Hey, what is going on, everybody? Jerma here with a gameplay commentary on Team Fortress 2. This is going to be a one-life gameplay with the Scout, using the default scattergun, the Criticola, and the Sandman. This is the first time I've ever equipped the Sandman in a commentary, ever. And not just a commentary. I haven't put this thing on probably since it came out back in like 2008 or 9, whenever they released this thing. I haven't used it once since then. This is also on CP Gravel Pit, and it's on defense if you couldn't already tell. Now here, let me tell you why I'm playing Scout. Scout on Gravel Pit on defense is really, really awesome, because if you can see in the bottom of the screen, they have to capture these two points, and you can go back and forth between these two points very, very quickly. So if somebody gets on A, you can run to A. If somebody gets on B, you can run over to B. The other classes don't really have that luxury. If you're playing a soldier or a heavy or something like that, or even a pyro, even one of the normal speed classes, you can't go back and forth between A and B that quickly. So a lot of times what will happen is somebody will sit on one point, let's say A, and if B is getting captured, they'll just let it get captured because they don't want to leave their position at A and have them cap A as well. This happens in 95% of every single gravel pit gameplay I've ever been on. And the way to combat it is you need a couple of good scouts. If you have two, maybe three scouts on defense on Gravel Pit, and they're doing this running back and forth between the two points, and they're good, it's going to be really, really difficult for the blue team to cap any of the points. Especially because you have these structured, big, heavy bomb classes like the Heavy or the Demoman, and if they sit in their positions and they defend where they're standing, and you got these two or three scouts running back and forth to try and protect both of them, you can really close off a lot of choke points and you can really control the game. Now this particular gameplay started with A being captured already, but the tip still remains. If you want to try and prevent stuff like this from happening, from your entire team just stuffing onto B or stuffing onto A, you gotta get a good scout, you gotta get a couple of good scouts, and probably even a few engineers as well. Alright, freeze it right here. Want to talk about one quick little thing before we get back into this. This heavy right here is guaranteed going to kill me. If I keep moving forward, if I go after this heavy, I am definitely, there's zero chance I'm going to beat this guy. If this heavy has any aim at all, I'm dead. Never run yourself into death. If you see a heavy and there's an obstacle you can get around it as soon as possible, because guys, people have such short memories when it comes to scouts. If you don't kill a scout, chances are you're gonna say in your head, "Yeah, somebody else will deal with them." And everybody does that, and nobody ever deals with them. So use that to your advantage as many times as you can. So tip-wise, that's all I can really give you today, but let's talk about a couple of things in the game right now, especially the end of this game. You'll see what I'm talking about in a minute or so. It's ridiculous. For the time being, though, let's talk about what's going on the screen now. Scout tries to get me with a ball, which ends up being his demise because he doesn't have the extra couple shots that I had on him. Jumping up here with the ball. Nobody really pays attention to me when I do this, by the way. And I feel like it happens for a lot of people. I've been in this situation before as well, when a scout comes up here and just smokes you. And remember this guy's name. Remember that sniper. He's important in about 10 to 20 seconds. You'll see. Trying to get an overheal from this medic, but he totally ignores me, which really, really stinks, because I probably could have used it really bad right here. End up getting this scout jumping up into the corner again. This is the part I'm talking about. Now, everybody pay attention. This is ridiculous. So, I'm not sure if this was lag or what actually happened here, but watch. Insta-death. Let's do a little bit of Jerma investigative reporting here. So, take a look at what he's doing. He's facing completely and totally forward with his arrow cocked. Look it. He's not even looking at me, and somehow he magically kills me by shooting forward, but shooting to the right at the same time. I don't know. I really don't know. And watch the chat. Watch the chat. Ready? He says, hee-hee. Almost like he knew that was going to happen, or he planned it. And maybe it was just lag, and he's laughing about the lag. Not sure, but that's going to be the end of the game, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And if you like this video, go ahead and shoot me a like, and I'll see you guys all next time. Take care. Everybody.